Shooting guards are best known for being the go-to scorers of their teams. And with how much the game has evolved nowadays, there's still some two guards who remain very effective on the hard court. With us today to share their top five shooting guards of the MPBL, we have our hardworking MPBL commentators, Migs Gomez and the slasher coach, Rodney Santos. Gentlemen, welcome back.
Sir?
Yes, sir.
Okay, top five shooting guards of the MPBL. Let's go.
Sir?
Well, Mike Ayonayon. He has developed that shooting touch, although he is known as a slasher type of a player.
Like you, parang ikaw.
Oh, marami talaga nakaka-relate. At saka...
Sarili buhat eh.
Sabi, para ako talaga to.
Ako eh, no? Excellent open court player. Pero siyempre, wala niya i-develop. Well, i-develop yung shooting.
Well, that's his favorite. He would tell you that. He loves the open court and high-flying siya.
Yes.
I keep on repeating the magic in the air because of him. By the way, number 3 pick in the PBA draft. Congratulations to Mr. Ayonayon. That's how good he is.
Okay, next guy on the list.
Byron Villarias of Bataan. Dito, Miko, this is one of the most underrated players, if not the most underrated player in the MPBL. Established shooter siya for Bataan. Very loyal to their crowd as well. That's why, pag tumitira siya na tres on their home floor, lahat, giyaw na agad.
Oh, tsaka matutitin naman siya, parang hindi naglalaro eh. Parang hindi player.
Yeah, hindi siya
mukhang player. Pero pag nakita niya stats sa game, parang nakakasampung 3 points na to. So, ganun siya. Sabi nga ni Mitch, underrated pero very...
Underrated dahil sa, yun nga, hindi siya mukhang parang baller.
Hindi siya, oo. Pag nakita mo, isa, iba makasi makita mo, pag nakita mo, kahit hindi mo lala, player to. Ngayon hindi, parang dumaan na sa harap mo. Okay lang, player pala.
Yeah. Oh, tapos titirahan ka pa niya.
So, Byron, actually, just like alam mga, yung socks niya, ankle socks, or ano mo yung...
No, see. Hindi talaga kita.
Oh, hindi masyadong kita. And then yung gupit ng buhok niya.
Yes.
Diba, parang schoolboy yung dating.
So parang hindi mo siya seryosohin.
Yes.
Hindi ganyan yung makakatakutan.
Mm-hmm.
And then bigla na lang yung makakalimang 3
points
na.
Pero, very effective.
Okay, next guy.
Yves Sazon of Marikina Shoe Masters. Sabi ko nga kay Michelle, pinag-usapan namin, kahit tumatanggap siya ng, grabe yung focus niya, grabe yung attention niya pag shumot. Kahit tumanggap siya ng nakatalikod sa ring, pag humarap siya, he can still make it all a challenge shot eh. Kahit may kamay sa mukha niya, talagang, yun ang mga, pag parang favorite shot niya, top shot. Top shot.
Ito yung mas gusto pa yung may asintahan kaysa wide open.
Mas gusto yung mahirap kaysa sa madali.
Well, si Yves Sazon kasi, just as Coach Rodney mentioned, he's the master of the turnaround shots. Parang mas mataas pa yung percentage niya eh.
May mga player na ganyan, Rodney, di ba? Yung mas gusto yung may nakabantay.
Correct.
Tulad mo?
Gusto yung... Ganun, oo. Sakto-sakto nga.
Gusto ko basta magaling. Parang ako yan eh.
And Yves Sazon is capable of scoring 18 to 20 points in one half.
Wow.
On a regular basis. Yun nga lang, kailangan consistent siya na kailangan two halves eh. Kasi usually, mainit siya isang half. Yung other half, medyo tumatahimik.
Oh, pero misa, meron siyang isang quarter na talaga puro siya.
Streak shooter. Streak parang microwave doon.
Mm. Oh, okay.
Mabilisan. Okay, next shooting guard on the list.
Next shooting guard on the list, we have Ronjay Buenafe of the Bicol Volcanoes, one of the most established leaders in the league. Veterano, as we know.
Yes.
One of the leading playmakers as well. Si Ronjay kasi, with how much he has transformed, mula pagkabata, he will openly share to you na marami siyang natutunan dahil sa basketball, natauhan din siya. And now, when you speak to him, parang siyang prophet eh. Very wise as he speaks.
Dahil, yung learning experience niya sa PBA, tapos nawala siya, bumalik siya sa PBA, so parang sa MPBL, so parang yung ganun pa rin, parang hindi na bago. Kasi very disciplined sa katawan niya, nagpa-condition talaga siya. And yung kanyang shooting touch talagang hindi mo talaga maki-question, dahil talaga meron siya na ever since. So he has developed that feeling, yung kanyang game throughout his career. And meron siyang lusot, meron siyang jump shot, which is very important. So that's how you're going to survive. Eh. Diba? When you're playing basketball, is it pro or PBA or APBL?
Oh, I can imagine, ang dami niya sigurong kwento, no? At maituturo dun sa kanyang mga younger teammates. Last but not the least,
Paolo Javelona. Well, pinag-usapan nga namin, Paolo Javelona has developed that his shooting touch later on is...
Oh, kasi defensive specialist naman si Paolo.
He's a keeper stopper. So, nung college days niya. So, ang maganda ron, he can defend, he can play offense, he can be a go-to guy. So, at the same time, he can be a lockdown guy. So, mas okay.
There you go. Sabi na ni Coach Rodney, Paolo is excellent as a shooter, slasher.
Slasher.
And defender. I want to give some stats here, Tito Mico, dahil si Paolo nasa top 10 across a lot of categories. Points, assists, and steals in the league. So for me nga, he might actually have a case to finish in the mythical team, the second team, probably. Pero of course, marami pang strong cases dyan in the whole MPBL. Then again, it's his first season sa Liga ng Bawat Pilipino and he has done well.
Our top 5 shooting guards, Mike Ayonayon, Byron Villarias, Yves Sazon, Ronjay Buenafe, and Pau Pau Javelona. Thank you very much, Mr. Slasher.
Thank you, Sir.
Coach Rodney and Migs. Salamat. Thank you for joining us. I'm Mico Halili, and this has been The Score. We'll be right back.